Now we have to find the work done in the adiabatic process. We know that adiabatic process is the relation PV gamma equal to constant. And work is integral PdV, and where volume is from V1 to V2. So we can substitute here P, that means say this constant is K, so it is K oblique V raised to power gamma into dV. And this constant is taken out, integral V1 to V2, and this can be written as V raised to power minus gamma dV. And integrating, we will get V raised to power minus gamma plus 1 oblique minus gamma plus 1, and limits are from V1 to V2. And substituting the limits, it will be, because minus gamma plus 1 is a constant, so upper limit first, it is V2, 1 minus gamma, minus V1, 1 minus gamma. With the relation PV raised to power gamma, or we can also replace it with, we will have, it is equal to K by 1 minus gamma, and this K is replaced by PV gamma, and remaining is V2 1 minus gamma minus V1 1 minus gamma. That is equal to, it is 1 by 1 minus gamma, and we bring this K inside, and we will get P into, because this PV gamma is constant, so we can also write it as P1 V1 gamma, that is equal to P2 V2 gamma. And while we'll multiplying the K, we will take appropriate suffix. So for V2, we will consider it is P2 V2 raised to the power gamma. So it is P2 V2 raised to the power gamma into V raised to the power 1 minus gamma minus, and here for V1, it will be written as P1 V1 raised to the power gamma into V1 raised to the power 1 minus gamma. Hence, it is equal to 1 by 1 minus gamma, and it will be P2 V2 minus P1 V1. And from ideal gas equation, we know PV equal to nRT. So P1 V1 will be equal to nRT1, and P2 V2 can be written as nRT2. Therefore, it is 1 by oblique 1 minus gamma, and P2 V2 is written as nRT2 minus nRT1. Hence, we will have, it is equal to 1 by 1 minus gamma, and nR is also taken out, and remaining is T2 minus T1. Hence, we can write work done in adiabatic process is nR oblique, because gamma is greater than 1, so we write in the format gamma minus 1, and one negative sign is taken out of this 1 minus gamma, so this negative sign is bring inside the bracket, so we will have T1 minus T2. So this is the work done in the adiabatic process. Let's take one of the question based on the adiabatic process. Question is, suppose an ideal gas having the initial pressure P, volume V and temperature T. That means the ideal gas which satisfy or obey the equation PV equal to nRT has initial pressure, that is P1 equal to P, V1 equal to V, and T1 equal to T, is allowed to expand adiabatically. The process is adiabatic process. So for adiabatic process, we know that PV gamma equal to constant. That means if initial pressure is P1, initial volume is V1, then its raised to power gamma is equal to P2, that is the final pressure, V2, that is the final volume, raised to the power gamma, until its volume becomes 5.66 V. That means V2 equal to 5.66 V. And temperature fall, that is T2 is equal to, final temperature is T by 2. Then how many degree of freedom, this DOF refers degree of freedom. As for example, we know that monatomic gas has the 3 degree of freedom, diatomic gas has the 5 degree of freedom. How many degree of freedom do the gas molecule have? So we have to find the number of the degree of freedom. To calculate the degree of freedom, we can use the parameter gamma, which is the ratio of specific heat at constant pressure and molar specific heat at constant volume, and we know that this value is 5 by 3 for mono atomic gas. It is 7 by 5 for diatomic gas. Here it refers degree of freedom is equal to 3, and this diatomic gas has degree of freedom equal to 5. So first we have to calculate the gamma. For adiabatic process we know that PV gamma equal to constant, and also TV gamma minus 1 equal to constant, which we have already calculated. So using this relation, TV raised to power gamma minus 1, because we know the temperature and volume, so we can write that T1 V1 gamma minus 1 is equal to T2 V2 gamma minus 1. This implies that this is T into V1 is V raised to power gamma minus 1 equal to T2 is T by 2 into V2 is 5.66 V raised to power gamma minus 1. Here this T get cancelled, 2 equal to, this 2 is taken on left hand side, and this V raised to power gamma minus 1 get cancelled, and remaining is 5.66 into raised to power gamma minus 1. Or we can say that taking the log on the both sides, it is the log 2 is equal to gamma minus 1 into log 5.66. Or we can say gamma minus 1 equal to log 2 by log 5.66. And using the log table, if we calculate it, we will get it as 0.4. So gamma equal to 1.4, or it is 7 by 5. Therefore, we have already mentioned that for gamma equal to 7 by 5, degree of freedom is 5. So we can say degree of freedom is 5 for this ideal gas. Next part is, obtain the work done by the gas during the expansion as a function of initial pressure P and the volume V. So to find the work done for the adiabatic process, we know the relation W adiabatic process equal to, it is NR T1 minus T2 divided by gamma minus 1. Here N is the number of moles, R is the universal gas constant, T1 is the initial temperature, T2 is the final temperature, and gamma is the ratio of the specific heats at constant pressure and constant volume. We know that in the given question, T1 is T and final temperature T2 is T by 2. So we can write, and we have calculated gamma equal to 1.4, for which degree of freedom of the gas are 5. So it is NR T minus T by 2 divided by 1.4 minus 1. Hence it can be written as NR into T by 2 divided by 0.4, or we can write it is NRT by 0.8, or it is, on simplifying, we can write it is 1.25 into NRT, because we have to find the work in terms of the initial pressure and volume. Initial pressure is P and initial volume is V, and initial temperature T1 is T, it is given in the question. Therefore, using the ideal gas equation, which is also obeyed by the adiabatic process, that P1 V1 equal to NRT1, and substituting the values in this equation, we will have PV equal to NRT. Therefore, from this equation, the value of the NRT can be replaced with PV. So in terms of PV, the work done in the adiabatic process will be 1.25 PV. This is the answer.